Morning, children. So the last class we discussed about PIL, right?
Yes, ma'am. Yes,
public ma'am. Interest litigation, and I told you the four pictures are given there in the textbook. I hope we want to explain that topic today.
Yes, ma'am.
Yes. So what do you mean by public interest litigation, Krishna?
Ma'am, Supreme Court has made a
think and answer. What do you mean by public interest litigation?
Ma'am, for the poor people, they can approach through this.
Who is giving? How? Who can approach?
Ma'am, lower caste people.
They've been reading the textbook and coming to the class. Yes.
Ma'am.
Yes. Jeevan, can you say what do you mean by public interest litigation?
Then people can file a case in the court for their high court or supreme court for invading their rights or right.
Who will say correct definition?
Ma'am.
Yes, Prarthana.
Ma'am, it allows any individuals or organizations to file the PIL if their right is violated.
Krishna?
Yes, ma'am.
What do you mean by PIL? Public interest litigation. That is an important topic, children. Okay. What do you mean by public interest litigation? That means if any individual or an organization can file a case either in High Court or Supreme Court on behalf of an individual whose right is violated, right? Yes. On behalf of any individual, we can file, either an individual, any individual or an organization can file a case in the Supreme Court or High Court if they feel that the right is violated. We are filing that case not for us. We are filing a case for any other individual. Clear, children? Don't forget that definition. What do you mean by PIL? Public interest litigation. That means any individual or an organization can file
a PIL.
A PIL either in Supreme Court or in High Court. Don't say court. Either they can file a case in Supreme Court or in High Court on behalf of an individual whose right is being
violated.
That is PIL. And nowadays, how we can file a PIL? Through a letter or a telegram or an email, we can file a PIL. Why this PIL was introduced by the Supreme Court? Because for the poor people or the uneducated and illiterate people or the daily wage earners, for accessing justice for quotas, for them it is very costly and it is a time consuming. To avoid such problems, the Supreme Court introduced this PIL, public interest litigation. As per the PIL, any individual, don't forget this definition, any individual or an organization can file a PIL either in Supreme Court or High Court on behalf of an individual whose right is being
violated.
So even though the poor people, if they have no money also, no problem. On behalf of them, any other person can file a case in the court. Clear?
Yes,
ma'am. That is PIL, public interest litigation. Then, you heard about the midday meal programs in the school?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes?
Yes, ma'am.
The government schools and also in the aided schools. That is the schools which is coming under the government. You heard about aided schools?
Yes.
That we studied in the second chapter, right? Secularism. The government is giving grants for the schools, which is coming under a particular community. You remember that?
Yes, ma'am.
so that either government or in aided schools nowadays this food for work the midday meal program is given, giving free food to the children till 14 years. It is free for all the children.
Your videos, ma'am. Ma'am.
Connection when it's
connected issue. Vent.
Electricity vent over here.
Safa, pause the recording.
Okay, ma'am.
Yes, okay. Okay, then that midday meal program. This midday meal program started in the schools as a result of a public interest litigation. Okay, this midday meal program started in the school as a result of the public interest litigation. So in page number 61, four pictures are given.
Yes.
So that? Yes.
Yes.
What is
yes.
The first picture?
In 2001, the drone in Rajasthan and Orisha
meant that millions faced an acute shortage of food.
Shortage of food. That means a drought was there in Rajasthan and Orisha, and there is an acute shortage of food grains in that states. And what was the second picture?
Meanwhile, the government godowns were full of grains, often this was being eaten by riots.
Two controversial situations. One situation, the people are suffering with lack of food. And the second situation, who is eating the food?
The rats.
The rats are eating the food because the godowns are full and rat is eating the food. Okay, then the third one.
Ma'am, it's a situation of hunger amidst plenty. An organization called the People's Union of Civil Liberties of PUCL filed a
PUCL. An organization? PUCL. CL. What is its full form?
People's Union of Civil Liberties.
See here, an organization file a case. Okay. So PIL, either an individual or an organization. Here, an organization called PUCL. They file a PIL, public interest litigation in the court.
It's
yes, and it stated the fundamental right of the people. Which fundamental right?
Life.
We studied, you remember the fundamental rights? We have six fundamental rights, and one of the most important among that fundamental right is right to life.
Equal.
That right to life include
the right to food.
Do you think so?
Yes, ma'am. Yes.
The person who want to live, what he need first?
Food. Water.
First, whatever it is, first we need food, right?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes. So the right to life include right to food, and so they file a PIL, public interest litigation in the Supreme Court by stating that there is a violation of the fundamental right, that is the right to life among the people. Okay. And what is the fourth?
It therefore directed the government to provide more employment, to provide food at cheaper prices through government ration shops, and to provide midday meals to children. It also appointed two food commissioners to report on the implementation of government.
So in the third one, the PUCL, they file a public interest litigation in the Supreme Court, and the Supreme Court ruled that the state has a duty to provide food for all. It is a duty of the state because the food godowns. The godowns, you heard about FCI, the Food Corporation of India, its godowns. If we have any food scarcity or shortages in the future, we are keeping some of the food grains there as a stock. So the court is saying that food godowns are full. But many people, many areas, the people are dying because of lack of food. So it is a duty of the government to ensure the safety of the people and protect the right of the people. And the court ordered that the state must provide food for all and also give food to the children from the school. That's why the midday meal programs were started in the schools. Okay, that's why the midday meal programs were started in the schools and also provide the food grains at a cheap rate through the ration shops. You heard about ration shops?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Yes. Yes, ma'am.
Nowadays also we are getting food grains from ration shops, right?
Yes, yes, yes. Yes, yes.
So if your card is BPL, you heard about APL, BPL cards?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, yes.
Ma'am. If anybody have a pink card?
Ma'am, white ma'am. Card I have.
Sunday,
ma'am.
We'll get
white card, blue. Okay. White is blue as coming as IPL.
Blue.
Pink.
Blue and white, APL. Pink means you are BPL, below poverty line.
Ma'am,
Shankari BPL.
Ma'am, my mom.
Don't hit anyone, okay? Ma'am, yes.
Ma'am, my eight is white card.
White card, yes. White card is in the APL itself, two classifications are
ma'am,
there.
Blue
is coming under. Blue, white, and all are APL. Yes. APL itself, they're divided into two.
Ma'am, why?
Having white.
And four.
Sorry, Shimanya.
Ma'am, why they are giving divisions for?
Yeah.
That is for giving those. See, if you have a BPL card, that means you are in below poverty line. Our government is deciding a poverty line. Okay, that in detail you will study in the next class. What is poverty, poverty line, and all. So that means based on a particular income, that is around 816 rupees for an individual is calculated, and depending on the states and all, it will change. But normally. Below the 1,000 rupees for an individual, we are considering for dividing the cards, APL and BPL. And if your card is BPL, that means in your family, no one have a proper income. Or a daily wage earners are there. And only if they have not much wealth and all, they are coming under BPL, below poverty line. And they are getting a pink card. If you have a pink card, you will get the rice and all at a free of cost. No need to pay any money. And also so many other advantages they are getting. So many card means if your income is above that particular level, you are belonging to APL. And white card grains at free of cost. If you have a BPL card.
Okay, ma'am.
Okay. Yes. Through the ration shops. And also to provide food grains through the ration shops at a cheaper price and also provide midday meal to the children. That program, I think you heard about it, midday meal programs.
Yes, ma'am.
Yes. For the government schools and all, the noon food is free for the children.
Ma'am, it was first found in January.
Louder?
Ma'am, it was first found.
Not in Kerala, but now Kerala, it is a very successful program.
Ma'am, Jharkhand, it was first conducted.
Yes. And Rajasthan, because of these states, this program was introduced. So that is the reason why this midday meal program was introduced in the school. How the midday meal program is introduced in the school? As a result of a public interest litigation. Clear?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes. So the court says that it is a responsibility of the state to ensure or to protect the fundamental right of the individual, and the right to life include the right to food also. By saying that, it says that it is a duty of the state to ensure the food safety or food security of the people of the country and introduce this midday meal schemes in the schools. Then, but some of the verdicts, so many verdicts are there from the court, but some of the verdicts are not up to the expectation of the people, or some of the judgments, the people believe that it work against their interest. Okay, some verdicts, the people feel that it was against their interest. And it is explained with the example of Olga Tellis versus Bombay Municipal Corporation. A case that is Olga Tellis versus Bombay Municipal Corporation. You saw that is in page number 62.
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, what is it? Just read it. 2 minutes.
That box.
Quickly. Read it and summarize it, okay?
Which one one can say again?
Not clear.
You can say again which one we should do.
Which page number? 62.
Ma'am, your video is off.
Olga Tellis versus Bombay Municipal Corporation.
Page number.
Your video is off.
What is the page number?
62.
Page number 62, children. Didn't see that?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes. Finished?
Ma'am, your video is off.
Louder?
Your video is off.
It is off.
Yes. Okay, what was the case? It is related to that. Many of the people, there is a verdict like that. The many of the people who want to move from the lack of persons who live in pavements and in slums in the city of Bombay, and they want to fly from that place. And what happened? They approached the court. And they ask for a judgment that they cannot be evicted from their shelter without being offered alternative accommodation. Because the Article 21 also guarantees a person the right to life.
Life.
So their life is on pavement. And if they are plied from that place, they have no other place to live.
Yeah.
Okay. So sometimes the verdict may be not in favor of the people. So they approach the court. And also another important problem of our judiciary is that it will take so many years for hear a case. Do you think so?
Yes, ma'am.
Is it possible to get a verdict within 1 or 2 days?
No.
Or 1 or 2 months?
No.
Taking so many time. Okay, so another issue that affect the common person's access to justice is the long number of years taking. When we are taking any of the cases, we can see that it will take many years for the completion of a case. The last class you asked about the Nirbhaya case, right? We discussed about
it.
It happened in 2013, but the verdict came in 2019. Then Ayodhya appeal is there. It was happened in 1990s, but the verdict came in 2000. Final verdict in 2000. So many cases are there. These are the controversial and the relevant cases. That's why. So many cases are there, but it is taking too much time. So we can say a sentence that justice delayed is justice denied. Delay means same as the justice denied. So you heard about a judge called Justice K.G. Balakrishnan?
No, ma'am.
It was the first Malayali Chief Justice in Supreme Court, okay? The first Malayali Chief Justice in Supreme Court, that is Justice K.G. Balakrishnan. And his words are given there. The Indian judiciary consists of a Supreme Court with 26 judges. See, children, that data is not updated one. Now it's around 34 judges are there. And now it is not... Sorry, Shivanya.
Ma'am, can you say the judge's name?
Justice K.G. Balakrishnan. He was a former Chief Justice of India and also a former Chairman of the Human Rights Commission also. So this is given as per the 2006 data, but now it is 2020. So the number of judges were increased. Now in Supreme Court, around 34 judges are there. And also not 21 high courts. Now how many high courts we have? 25. Okay. 25 high courts are there. And the judges is almost around 1,079 judges are there in the high courts, and also around 16,1190 judges in the trial courts or in the district courts through all over the country. But even though some cases the justice is delayed, but even though we are saying that the justice is delayed and it has some problem, but judiciary and independent judiciary is necessary for upholding the value, especially the democratic values we are following. We discussed what happened if the judiciary is not independent. The judiciary is not independent, it will be act for someone. So we, the final trust of the people is a verdict from judiciary, right?
Yes, ma'am.
We believe that the judiciary is there to uphold the fundamental right of the individuals and also to protect the values that we are upholding in a democratic form of government. So even though we are saying that it will be a delay in decision making and some verdicts are in not favor of the people, but when we are analyzing the importance of judiciary, we can conclude that an independent judiciary is necessary for a country to uphold the fundamental right of the enforce the fundamental right of the individual and also to uphold the values of democracy. Okay. That's all about the chapter judiciary. So children, which are the major topics we discussed in that chapter? Only the topic I will say. Just listen here. First we begin with the chapter.
Ma'am. Shangiri, pause the recording.
Connectivity issue. Okay, then that's all about the chapter. So I no time. Ah, yes, 5 minutes are there, right?
10:45 only.
10:40. Ah, okay. So we have time. So how to define judiciary?
Judiciary means court which interpret and apply laws.
Yes, the court which interpret and apply law. Then, so we discussed first about what is a judiciary. Judiciary means it's a court which interpret and apply law. Then we studied.
Ma'am, the three organ.
Ma'am, divide into three.
Yes, judiciary. You must understand the question first, okay? Otherwise, how we will write the exam? The role of judiciary or how? To how is the work of judiciary categorized? Role or work of judiciary is categorized into three. That is
dispute resolution, judicial
resolution,
judicial review,
upholding the laws and enforcing fundamental rights. Upholding the laws and enforcing
fundamental rights.
Upholding the laws and enforcing the fundamental rights. Then we discussed what do you mean by an independent judiciary.
The other branches of government cannot interfere in the work of the judiciary.
Yes, that means the judiciary, there is no influence from any other branch of the government. That is, there is separation of power. Judiciary is independent from legislature and executive. And we discussed what happened if the judiciary is not independent. You remember that politician's example?
Yes.
If we encroached in the land, if the judiciary is not independent, the judge will take a decision in favor of him. But if it is an independent judiciary, there is no, the judge is not, even though it is appointed by the president, but the executive have a least role after appointing him. Then the structure of court. The structure of court include
Supreme Court, High Court, District Court.
Always remember this. Triangle or pyramid. Here the last is
district.
Then you remember our country, right? District. After district, what is it?
High Court, Supreme Court.
Okay. Then the courts are connected to each other. The decision taken by the higher court is binding to the lower court. And it can be understood through the appellate system that exists in India. That we explained in the case of Lakshman and Sudha.
Ma'am, Apex Court in state is High Court.
High Court. Apex Court in India is Supreme Court. Apex Court in the state is
High Court.
Then the different
High Court is presided by Chief Justice.
Both the courts, High Court and Supreme Court is presided by the Chief Justice. One is the Chief Justice of Supreme Court and the other is Chief Justice of
High Court.
Then the next is branches of
Legal System.
Legal System. Which are the two branches?
Civil and criminal.
Criminal means offense. Civil means?
Violation of rights.
Very good. Criminal and civil. Then the next important topic is
PIL.
Public interest litigation. That means any individual or organization can file a PIL in the court on behalf of
a person who fights.
Ma'am.